too early to tell. The first thing that has happened is a much heightened degree of uncertainty. I think if the Democratic candidate had won, we would have known that there would be continuity. Perhaps that's why she lost, because in the...
They're looking for change candidate.
Yeah, they're looking for change. This is part of a trend worldwide of people who are discontented with the inequality that has come partly as a result of globalization, and they're complaining, and they're getting politicians that are more nativist, and certainly in the case of Donald Trump, who is appealing to the middle of America, you have people that have been affected much more by the offshoring of jobs in manufacturing, and for that matter, in BPOs.
So you talk about the term vulnerability here. One of the things that Nomura Global Research talked about, that the Philippines is highly vulnerable towards potentially protectionist policies. Now, which sectors, which companies do you think are going to be affected here in the Philippines in terms of the U.S. investments and the Philippine economy in general?
In the first place, the TPP, which did not involve the Philippines, but involved 12 APEC members and represented 40% of global GDP, is dead. There is a 100-day program that Donald Trump issued in October. And first of all, within the first 100 days, with respect to trade, he will initiate a renegotiation of NAFTA, which affects several million U.S.
Absolutely.
Jobs.
Absolutely, people below and above the border in the U.S.
And on both borders, both on Canada, above the border, and in Mexico below the border. And there's a tremendous amount of supply chain linkages involved there, and millions of American jobs that would be affected if you withdrew. It's a withdrawal. It's inward looking. It's going to cost, if these things are carried out, or for example, the threatened tariff with Mexico, the threatened tariff with China.
45% level threat, yeah.
Yeah, and then many of the people that voted for him are going to find the prices of goods at Walmart are going to double. There would be inflationary.
Given all the sourcing there.
So I'm not sure. But I mean, there's great uncertainty right now, not just on trade, but also in foreign policy all over the world. And I think the first way in which the uncertainty will be resolved is to see who the president-elect is naming.
What other milestones are you looking at? I mean, you've got this transition team still cranking out any of these, you know, structures and names, but which specific signposts are you looking at for a Trump presidency so the business community has some confidence or lack of thereof?
Well, I think, you know, look at what he's going to send up to the Congress right away. He's going to send up a tax reform. Now, infrastructure, he's very big on infrastructure, and he's going to send a proposal up to do a lot in infrastructure. Then Obamacare. There are now 20 million Americans signed up for Obamacare, many of which probably voted for President Trump. So I think he's going to be a little bit cautious on that. And then something very interesting, he spent 90 minutes with President Obama. There's some speculation, maybe it's just in the liberal press, such as the New York Times, mm-hmm. that President Obama may counsel the new president on some of the more difficult challenges of being president. So I'm actually optimistic that Donald Trump, the president, will be different than Donald Trump,
the candidate,
because he campaigned without a lot of specifics, mm-hmm. but on emotion. Tremendous rhetoric in order to get elected.
Well, listen, John, one thing we talk about also is the incentives to bring American jobs back home and, you know, steady infrastructure, strong manufacturing. How does that affect the manufacturing sector here or even the service sector given the BPOs?
Well, let's be frank. The Philippine trade exports are not strong in comparison to others in Southeast mm-hmm. Asia. Vietnam has tripled their exports in the last decade of goods, and the Philippines, they're flat. But the semiconductor industry is about 60% mm-hmm. of total exports. Now, it doesn't all go to the United States directly. A lot of it goes up through China.
Through the supply chain, right?
It goes into things like what is in my pocket, an apple, mm-hmm. right? I think Silicon Valley is a little bit worried about Trump and technology. Obama embraced technology. Now, Trump has actually talked about Apple making more of its final products in the United mm-hmm. States. Well, one of the elements in every Apple is made in the Philippines, either at Clark or up in Baguio. Mm-hmm. May go to China to be assembled. So will that company, which has invested a lot here, have to make more of those products in the United States?
What does it do for the final product and its competitiveness as a company?
Well, he's talked about talking to the CEOs of Apple or Ford, et cetera, to move more jobs back to the United States. And the fact of the matter is that manufacturing jobs have not been going offshore, certainly not to Asia as much as they used to. More of them are coming back from China into the United States. But they're also being replaced by technology. More jobs in the manufacturing sector of the United States have been lost to technology and artificial intelligence mm-hmm. and to robots than going offshore.